It reminds me of a story about another little person. And I especially think of this story because it also has a little flap at the bottom of a door. Only in this case, it's not for Mama's leg. Let me tell you about it. This is a story about a little boy named Nicholas. Now, when Nicholas was born, he was smaller than all of the other boys and girls. And when his mommy and his daddy first saw him, they looked down and they said, "My, what a teeny tiny little boy." And Nicholas, he wished he could say, "I'm not teeny tiny. I'm my size. That's Nicholas' size. And that's the perfect size." But of course, he didn't know how to talk yet. Well, a short time later, his grandma and his grandpa came to visit, and they looked down, and they too said, "My, what a teeny tiny little boy." And Nicholas wanted to say, "I'm not teeny tiny, I'm my size. That's Nicholas' size, and that's the perfect size." But he didn't know how to talk yet. Every day, Nicholas grew a little bit bigger, but he was still smaller than all the other boys and girls his age. And every day he learned how to do new things. It wasn't long before he could hold his head up on his own and look around and see the world. And it wasn't long before he could lift himself up on one arm and roll over onto his back, and then roll back the other way, and pretty soon he could sit up all by himself. And Nicholas, he loved to sit out on the front porch of the house. And one day he was sitting there in the sunshine, and the man who brings the mail came up. The mailman looked down and said, "My, what a teeny tiny little boy." Nicholas looked up. He wanted to say, "I'm not teeny tiny. I'm my size. That's Nicholas' size. And that's the perfect size." But he still didn't know how to talk. Well, Nicholas kept on getting bigger, but he was still smaller than all the other boys and girls his age. And he kept learning to do new things, too. It wasn't long before he could get himself up on his hands and knees and crawl around. And one thing Nicholas loved to do was to go for long stroller rides in the park with his mommy and his daddy. And one day they were walking along. Daddy was pushing the stroller and mommy was walking, and there was a nice old lady feeding some birds on a bench. And they rolled Nicholas over. She looked down and she said, "My, what a teeny tiny little boy." And Nicholas wanted to say, "I'm not teeny tiny. I'm my size. That's Nicholas' size. And that's the perfect size." But he still didn't know how to talk. But he kept on getting bigger. He was still smaller than all the other boys and girls his age, and he kept on learning how to do new things. And one day, Mommy and Daddy and Nicholas came back from one of those stroller rides in the park. Daddy pushed the stroller right up onto the porch, and Daddy looked at Mommy, and Mommy looked at Daddy, and Daddy said, "Dear, don't you have the keys for the house?" And Mommy said, "No, dear, I thought you had the keys." Daddy said, "No, you always bring the keys." And Mommy said, "No, you told me you were bringing the keys." And Daddy said, "No, you..." And Mommy and Daddy started to talk at each other really loudly. You know how that can be sometimes? And while Mommy and Daddy were talking at each other so loudly, Nicholas was learning how to do new things. Nicholas was learning how to unfasten the strap that kept him in the stroller. And while Mommy and Daddy were talking back and forth, Nicholas slid out of that stroller and he crawled across the porch to the front door of the house. And down at the bottom of the door was a little flap that the cat used to get in and out of the house. And that little cat door was small. It was small like Nicholas. That little cat door was Nicholas size. And so he crawled right through that flap, and the cat door swung up and then back down, and Nicholas was inside the house. And he crawled down the hall and into the dining room. And he looked up on the dining room table, and there was a sleeve of a shirt dangling down, and he could just reach his hand up. He grabbed a hold of that shirt sleeve and he pulled it down. All kinds of laundry fell on top of him, and he crawled out from under the pile of those clothes, and a pair of pants was on his head, and he shook it off, and he crawled into the kitchen. And he started opening some cabinets. And he found the cabinet with the pots and the pans, and he started to bang those together, and he put them all over the floor, and he banged on them, and oh, it was so much fun. And then he crawled into the living room. And there in the living room was the big sofa, and in front of the sofa was a little table. And Nicholas reached up one hand and put it on the top of that table, and then the other hand on top of that table, and he used the table to pull himself up to his feet. And Nicholas was standing on his own 2 feet, and he looked, and there on that table he saw something shiny. It was like a ring with shiny things on it. And Nicholas reached out. He could just reach that shiny metal ring with those shiny things on it, and he pulled it off the table with a ka-ching, ching, ching. And Nicholas picked it up, and he jingled it, and he jangled it, and he decided to show it to Mommy and Daddy. So he put that ring, that metal ring, in his mouth with those metal shiny things jingling and jangling as they dangled out of his mouth, and he crawled back through the kitchen and back through the dining room and back through the hall to the front door, and he crawled through that cat door. It swung up and then back again. He crawled out onto the porch, and he dropped that shiny metal ring with a ka-ching, ching, ching, jingle right on the porch. And Mommy and Daddy stopped talking at each other, and they looked down, and Daddy said, "Nicholas! Nicholas, you found the keys." Mommy said, "Nicholas, where did you find the keys?" And Daddy pointed. He said, "Look, dear, the cat door." Nicholas went in through the cat door and got the keys. And they scooped him up, and together they gave him a big hug. And Mommy and Daddy said, "Nicholas, it's a good thing you're so small." They said, "Nicholas, you're not teeny tiny. You're the perfect size." And Nicholas thought, "I could have told you that if I knew how to talk." And that's the story of Nicholas size.
I love that. I love that. I could just see Nicholas climbing and crawling all through your house.